Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. And in this video I want to show you the option that you can buy on a B2 series from Europe, the original front hitch and front PTO from Kubota. The front hitch has a lift capacity of 500 kilograms. I showed already some examples of implements in other videos, and there was a special request to tell more about this original option from Kubota. My previous compact tractor, the Kubota B1600 DT, was only equipped with a backside hitch. And when I was looking for a replacement, I came with this tractor, 26 horsepower B2 series. So the front hitch is operated by the joystick. Up and down is forward, backward on the joystick, and left and right controls the hydraulic flow in these hydraulic connections. The front hitch delivers both force upward as well as downward when you move the joystick, and when you push it all the way forward, it goes into floating mode. Now, floating mode is something which is very good when you have something rolling in front of you, like the flail mower or the rotary broom, where you really want the implement to just follow the level of the ground in front of it instead of pushing it in some direction. The floating speed can be adjusted by a valve, adjustment valve, which I will show, which also determines how fast the implement will go down when you push into floating mode. And that's something that you can control by turning on this valve. So this way you adjust the resistance of the hydraulics. This is an adjustable resistance valve that controls how fast that movement is going to be. You can also close it off completely by closing this valve on top. The front PTO has a rotating speed of 1000 RPMs. And here you see the knob that you can use to turn on the front PTO. Now the light is on. PTO is running. Off. So we have the front PTO as an option. I now have three independent controllable PTOs: the rear PTO, the mid PTO, and the front PTO. And the front PTO is made by Zuidberg. Now it's quite difficult to make the drive visible. We're now looking at the front side, at the pulley that also drives the radiator fan as well as the dynamo. And you can see that there's an extension of this front X using a universal joint that goes into the front PTO of Zuidberg. So this front PTO is driven directly from the engine using a universal joint, as I was trying to show you on the video. The switch of the front PTO is at the side, which I can do from the seat. It's an electromagnetic switch, so then it turns on the front PTO separately from the back PTO and the mid PTO. So originally the safety cover was present, but with the safety cover on, you really had to go with your hand in between the shaft and the cover to connect it. It really felt awkward and unsafe. I didn't like it, so I took it off, and I was a quick connection, much simpler, and I don't really see the benefit of having this cover on. For connecting an implement, the quick attach A-frame is quite handy. You can simply install it onto the front side. So Kubota does not use the quick attach connection that you can control from the seat, like some other tractors do. Instead, they use an M16 thread that you need to secure from the top. Sometimes I use this bolt like this, which you can simply use without a tool. But for other implements, there's not enough room for it, and then I use a small bolt with the ring. The angle of the A-frame is important, because if the angle is wrong, it will not want to connect towards the implement, and with the you can adjust the angle using the top bar and thereby changing the jaw angle, and you can secure it via the slip. Now when I want to use the front loader, I need to take the A-frame off because there's not enough room, but that's done quite quickly. So there it is. And as you can see, there's also a possibility to tow the trailer from the front. So let's demonstrate the movement up and down with the front hitch. Here you can see the side of the hitch, made for Kubota by Kova. The original Kubota exhaust was blowing straight over the left cylinder of the front hitch. And as you can see in the video on this, I welded in a stainless steel exhaust band in order to prevent that. So now the exhaust is blowing away in a different direction. So in order to be able to use both the front hitch as well as the front loader, the hydraulics had to be adapted. My dealer consulted Kubota for that, how to make that. They installed these hydraulic valves by which you can control whether to use the front hitch or whether to use the front loader. So now I can use both. For me, the front hitch and front PTO was an interesting option that Kubota offered, so I took it. And also the quick attach A-frame, I think it's a very nice option. You just simply drive towards the implement. Sometimes you need to adjust the jaw angle a little bit using the top bar, and then you can simply hook up the implement and lock it by the bolt. It's a very fast and simple way to connect an implement at the front. The disadvantage of the front hitch is that the ground plane is getting smaller. That was a disadvantage that I really had to think about, but I think that the advantages of the front hitch are quite large, and that's why I decided to go for it. I really like the front mounted implements, especially because of the very good view you have. Also, of course, with the flail mower, where you really mow the bush or mow the grass before you go over it with your tractor. And also that you can have a direct view on your work when you're doing like the weed brush or rotary broom. That's something that I really like. I have already a few implements that I use on this tractor. I'm sure more will follow, also for the front loader. And very happy with how it all operates.